Well, folks, do I have a value-packed video for you here today. I'm gonna give you 5 loopholes on how you can get to the riches, okay? If we go back 11 years ago, I was just a poor boy working at Walgreens, making, I don't know, $8.75 an hour, and I've been fortunate enough over the past years to get rich myself and see a lot of other people get rich, and I've seen, like, how they've done it, and I kinda wanna break down these loopholes in this video, and when I say a lot of other people get rich, I'm talking people young, too. I'm talking about people in their 20s and 30s get rich. Not like, oh, they're finally rich and they're like 68 years old, or oh, they're finally rich and they're like 82 or something like that. I'm talking in their 20s and 30s. And so in this video, I want to share with you exactly how it's done, how you can do it through these different loopholes. And by the way, if you're wondering, what do I personally consider rich? $3 million plus net worth, okay? If you have $3 million plus net worth, that is truly rich in my eyes, okay? Different people have different opinions on that, and that is fine. That's not what we're getting into in this video. I'm just telling you my perspective, and obviously, I mean, heck, some countries, you could have $1 million and you could be rich, okay? I'm talking United States of America and from my point of view. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. As always, if you don't mind, smash that thumbs up. We're gonna give out a lot of value in this video here today. Also, we just launched a few days ago the best free stock market investing Discord chat in the world. It's absolutely free to join. It will be the pinned comment down there. It's also linked in the description if you want to join and talk stocks with other folks. Stock Hub is the place to do it. By the way, oh my gosh, guys, we're already at almost 12,000 members. That is absolutely ridiculous. Like, we just launched a few days ago. Like, it's absolutely incredible. Let's get into this, guys. 5 loopholes on how to get rich. Number one, don't believe it is so hard, okay? You hear all the time, oh, it's the 1%. And so in your mind, you're just kind of like being brainwashed that, like, you're thinking, oh, it's just like 1% of people. So I have a 99% chance of not being rich and a 1% chance of being rich. And I can tell you, it is BS, okay? Complete BS. The way you're being brainwashed is so, it's just so ridiculous in my opinion, okay? The fact is, the high majority of people are not trying to get rich, okay? They're trying to live day to day, okay? They're not trying to get rich. They're not actively actually trying to get rich, okay? That's just facts, okay? And I'm talking the high majority of individuals. And I don't care what country we're talking about. We talk about my country, United States. The high majority of folks are not trying to get rich. Rich on an everyday basis, okay? They would love to be rich, but they're not trying to get rich, okay? And so what you're taught coming up in the system, you're taught go to college, take out some debt, you know, 30K, 50K, 70K, 100K, whatever it takes for you to get your bachelor's in college. If you want to go further than that, you know, you can go further, but at least get your bachelor's, okay? Go get a car. That's a bunch more debt, okay? And by the way, very high interest debt. And you're going to college, so hopefully you can get a 50K a year job, right? So you can get a, you know, a good job, make 50K, 60K a year, okay? Awesome. That's why you're going to college, all right? And then it's like get a house, go on vacation a couple times a year, get some pets, have some kids, okay? You know, I don't know about you guys, but man, you know, kids are the best thing that ever happened to me, but goodness, I can't imagine making 50K a year and trying to support kids and trying to go on vacations and have a house and have pets. I mean, my goodness, like how does that work? Like literally, how does that work? And how do you have any money left over ever to like invest? Just honestly, okay? It just, like, just run the math. It doesn't dang make sense, okay? I would say there's less than 5% of the population is actually trying to get rich or richer, okay? Less than 5%. I mean, it's a very small group of people that are actively out there actually trying to get rich. Just because you work at a job, okay, does not mean you're trying to get rich. That means you're trying to make ends meet so you can eat tomorrow and you can have a roof over your head. And that's the high majority of folks, okay? The high majority of folks are not trying to get rich or richer, okay? This is facts, okay? There's 18.6 million known millionaires in the United States alone, okay? And that was as of last year. I would say there's over 20 million now. Never mind folks that maybe aren't reported on those numbers, okay? That's just in the United States. If you live in the United States and you hear about getting rich, you absolutely can get rich, okay? It is not like, oh, I only have a 1% probability to get in there. No, okay? Absolutely not. I would say if you're actually trying to get rich, you're putting in the work to do it, and you're grinding on this day in and day out, I would say there's a 75% plus probability that you will get rich within 1 to 2 decades, okay? The whole, oh, I got a 1% chance to get rich, complete BS. I promise you, go to house by house across the United States, and I can tell you the majority of people in that house
are not trying to get rich, okay? That is factual, okay? So just get that out of your mind. I would say literally 75% probability you'll get rich within 1 to 2 decades if you actually care about it and you actually put in the work toward it. But the majority of people are not putting in the work. And I'm talking like 95% plus of people are not putting in the work toward this, guys. Facts, okay? Change your mindset, then we can start talking, okay? The number two loophole to get rich is invest as much as possible young. This is my favorite loophole of them all, and not a lot of people are ever even taught this, okay? Compounding is the most powerful thing in the universe when it comes to money. You want to get rich, invest young, okay? This is key. And it's not just compounding of money. It's compounding of money and it's compound of learning. I mean, I can't imagine like comparing myself nowadays as a stock market investor and picking stocks versus me 10 years ago. It's not even comparable. Never mind me 5 years ago. It's not even comparable because you learn more and more and more. And if you're grinding on this, you get better and better and better with your strategies, the way you're doing things, your approach. Never mind that. Your money continues to compound faster and faster. And as you get the snowball built bigger and bigger, a smaller gain is still a massive gain as you get the numbers bigger and bigger. Man, this is arguably the most powerful loophole I'll share with you in this video, okay? I mean, just invest your money young and keep at it, okay? Ideally before 20. If you can get started before 20, that is huge, okay? I started when I was like 18, 19. I've seen people in the channel that are like 14 years old, okay? 14, and they're investing. That's absolutely ridiculous. Leave me a comment if you're under 18 years old and you're investing through like a custodial account or something like that. That is beast, okay? Because I mean, imagine where you're, let's say you start investing when you're 14. Imagine where you're at when you're 24. Imagine where you're at by the time you hit 34 years old. You've been investing in the stock market, picking stocks for 20 years, okay? That's ridiculous to even think about, okay? In your 20s is massive. If you can get started in your 20s with investing, that is gonna be huge for you, okay? And you start picking stocks, oh my gosh, okay? You're gonna be set for life. Let's just put it that way, okay? In your 30s, you're still looking pretty good, okay? I mean, you know, you've let some time pass, but you're still looking pretty good if you get rolling in your 30s. Now, if you're starting in your 40s, you're starting way behind the eight ball, okay? I mean, you can still get rich in a decade or two, but man, you're starting way behind the eight ball, especially if you have limited savings. Now, if you're 40 and you're just starting investing, you got 300K, 500K, 700K in a savings account, okay, now we're talking, okay? But I mean, if you don't have anything really saved and you just start investing and saving, like, that's tough, man. In 50s plus, I don't wanna say it's impossible to get rich, but man, it's gonna be difficult. That's all I'm gonna say. So investing young is so dang key. Look at this, okay? Let's say somebody starts out when they're 20 years old. They put in 10K and they put in $1,000 a month, okay, toward their investment account. They do that for 30 years. They get a 15% ROI each and every year, which is a really good return. It's not a great return, but it's a really good return, okay? And let's say they do that for 30 years. Well, at 50 years old, this isn't including like if they bought a house and they paid that house off or anything like that or any other type of assets, just doing that in the stock market, this person will have over $5.8 million in the stock account, okay? That's, you don't need to do another thing for your entire life, okay? You got millions in stocks, never mind if you had bought a house along the way and hopefully you paid that house off. You know, oh my gosh. I mean, you were set for life and you can do most things. You can do whatever you want. Let's just be honest. You can go on whatever trips you want. You can buy whatever you want. You are looking good. Invest young, about the biggest loophole you will ever find out there to truly get rich, okay? Number 3 of 5 loophole to get rich is, hey, you know what this photo is here? It's an embarrassing photo of me. It's a horrible photo of me. Look at my eyes are closed. I don't like the way my face looks. It's just, I don't like the photo, okay? But that's one of the most powerful photos I have of myself right there. You know why? Because that was me collecting my first ever money I collected from starting a business in 2015. That was for my real estate marketing business. That was the first job I ever went on. It was a $99 job, and that was crazy, okay? Because that was the first time in my life, really, I had made money for myself, something I had put together rather than like a corporation or a company or something like that paying me out. And that was valuable. Number 3 of 5 loophole, start a dang business, okay? Start a business. This is a massive loophole in the system that not nearly enough people take serious or really try in a real way to get it together, okay? The corporate grind, this is facts, okay? There's a lack of income opportunity, okay? A huge lack of income opportunity when you do the corporate grind. I learned this firsthand working at Walgreens, okay? Where I was making $8.75. I mean, I don't, what would I be making if I was still working at Walgreens? 30K a year, 40K a year? Like, you know, even if I got promoted, what, I mean, goodness, maybe I'm making 50, 60K. There's such a lack of income opportunity. At Quick Trip was one of the best companies you can possibly work for. In terms of if you're trying to go on that corporate grind and like climb your way up the ranks and things like that, it's one of the best companies. I can tell you, man, sometimes it takes a year or sometimes many years just to get a promotion to maybe make an extra $5,000, $10,000 a year. I mean, that's what you call a limited opportunity, and that is a corporate grind, and that is pretty much all corporations out there, because you know why? Everybody wants that position, okay? Everybody's trying to get that position in the corporate grind because the people have been taught in their heads, like, oh, I gotta get a job at a corporation and try to work my way up the ranks. And so, you know, and you get into the politics of that, there's such a ridiculous lack of income opportunities when you're trying to climb the corporate ranks. I mean, it can take you 10 years just to make an extra $10,000 a year. I mean, it's crazy, okay? And you hear this sometimes, but the corporate grind, man, it's so safe. Your job is so secure when you work for those big corporations. And I don't even know what to say to that, man, other than laugh. I mean, just pull up anytime. It doesn't matter if we have a good economy, bad economy, sideways economy. There's constantly big corporations laying off employees. Chevron lays off 700, okay? Wall Street layoffs are just a matter of when, not if, sources say. Wells Fargo layoffs to hit most geographies in nearly all business lines. University layoffs are left and right. Disney's laying off 8,800. Disney's laying off another 28,000 employees. These are all just headlines from like the last week or so, okay? I mean, you could go just through the list. Massive amounts of layoffs. Your job is not safe at a big corporation, okay? Your job is safe until your boss comes in and says, we're gonna have to let you go, okay? Then your job's no longer safe. Like, how is that safety? That is not safety at all, okay? Absolutely not safety at all. We have around an 8% unemployment rate right now in the United States of America, around 8%. That means essentially, millions upon millions upon millions upon millions of people are out of work, more than likely because they got let go from their corporation, okay? You own your own business. You have unlimited earnings potential, literally unlimited, okay? Earnings potential and wealth building, okay? Doesn't mean you're gonna be the next Jeff Bezos or Elon Musk and you're gonna be worth $100 billion, but the fact is you have unlimited earnings potential with a business, okay? I mean, literally, you can build it wherever you wanna go, okay? Is where you wanna build it, okay? Number two, you can build it in a way that it's much safer than a corporate job, okay? Once again, a corporate job's good until the boss comes in and tells you, we don't need you anymore, you're too expensive now, we'll find somebody younger. We're going to outsource this to another country. Then your job's no longer safe. You can build a business in a way where it's far safer. You have way more customer diversity than anything you can get in the corporate grind world, okay? Guys, starting a business is massive if you really want to, you know, achieve a loophole of going your own way and really climbing those money ranks, okay? Unless you already got a great corporate job and you're making $100,000 plus a year, $150K, $250K, respect, okay? You're doing just fine. But I'm telling you, for a lot of you guys, you're making under $100K a year. And, it, you know, to climb the corporate ranks, it's gonna be dang difficult, okay? That's all I got to say. It's actually much easier and much more realistic to make 100K plus a year starting your own business. I've seen it with countless people around me throughout my entire life, okay? Number four of five up here, loopholes on how to get rich. Always invest in yourself. That is always the best investment you can make. The more you learn, the more you earn, okay? So last night, had dinner with Mr. Andre and Mr. Graham, okay? And like, what do you think we're like doing when we're like have dinner like that? You think we're just like talking about the weather and like, you know, I don't know, the latest sporting event or something? No, okay? It's a constant conversation of teaching and learning and teaching and learning and teaching and learning. And we're constantly talking about things that are working for us, things that aren't working for us. I remember last night, Andre was talking about, you know, why I should invest in this crypto and why this crypto. crypto is so big in the future, and we talk about YouTube and what's working and this and that, and we just go back on ideas and, hey, this has worked for me, this isn't, you know, it's just constant learning from each other, teaching each other. And this is every single time I get around anybody that is rich or trying to get rich. It's just a constant like conversation of things that are working, things that aren't working, what can we do, what can we do better, learning and teaching, okay? I mean, I even surround myself with people now who are constantly on this path of, you know, continuous learning. Blake sent me this last night. New book just came in, supposedly very insightful on, you know, stories of successful hedge funds in case we want to start a hedge fund down the road, okay? I'm consistently surrounding myself with people who aren't complacent and who want to continue to learn. And the question is, why be complacent, okay? Why be complacent? It just doesn't dang make any sense. Like, keep going. That's all we got to do. Just keep on dang going. I don't want to just sit around and do nothing all day. I always remember one of my favorite songs ever. It's a song called My First Song by Jay-Z. It's not a popular song at all. Just put it that way. It's at the end of the Black Album. And I don't remember the specific word choice, but I just remember loving that song because the intro. I don't know if Biggie did the intro or who's talking in that intro. And it's something like the key is, you know, to stay busy, stay working, keep hungry, keep learning. And I just remember, like, oh, it's just, I don't know, the way it came across was always just so powerful. I remember just listening to that song a lot in like 2008, 2009, and just loving it, just absolutely loving it. Because the fact is, you are never done learning, okay? I have been like paying such close attention to money and business and all these things for 12 years, and I consistently learn new stuff all the time, okay? I'm consistently looking into new stocks, new industries. Like, this is how it's done, okay? You wanna get rich, you wanna do things on a big scale, you gotta consistently keep learning. You can never get complacent. You can't just say, I know everything. Doesn't work that way, okay? Number 5 loophole up here of these 5 loopholes. If you are making 100K plus a year, or you're somebody that already has a half million plus in net worth, hire a great tax professional. They will save you way more money, and I'm talking way more money than you ever thought possible. If you make like 50K or less a year, and you got a net worth of under, you know, let's say $50,000, I don't think this is a positive ROI, but I can tell you, if you make 6 figures plus a year, or you have a half million dollars net worth or so, hire a great tax professional. And for all you guys that are not already rich or don't already have really good jobs, okay, trust me, remember this one, okay? When you get to that place, hire a great tax professional. The money you spend on them will be frivolous in such a small amount. I mean, it's one of the highest ROIs you will ever get. I can just tell you, since I started, you know, I used to file all my own taxes back in the day until finally I hired a tax pro. I think it was like 2018, 2017, 2018. And I mean, the ROI they got me was like 10x. I literally could not believe it. I didn't know there was this many different tax benefits you could do, and like, it's ridiculous. Hire a tax professional. But specifically, hire a tax professional in rich zip codes in your city. Don't just hire anybody anywhere, okay? Hire tax professionals in rich zip codes in your city. Why is this? These people work constantly with other rich people, okay? And so if they're working constantly with other rich people, they know all the tax benefits, they know all the loopholes in the tax system, they know it all down to a T, and you can talk with them and have conversations with them on what can we do here, what could we do there? Like, they know it all, okay? It's like, you know, when you really get into this stuff, it is huge. I mean, you're taught about the tax system. Oh, it's just you pay this percentage. It doesn't work like that at all. There's so many breaks and benefits. I can't even explain to you. I don't even know half the stuff. I don't even know a quarter of the tax code. I don't even probably know 10% of the tax code. Believe me, but these tax pros that work with rich people all the time, they know it all, okay? And it's absolutely amazing. It's one of the highest ROIs you will ever get, okay? I want you guys to come back to this video in future months and future years and, you know, watch it again and, you know, pick up on these things, remember these things for life, because they are the loopholes if you really want to get rich. This is coming from myself, who has done it, and coming from, you know, a ton of people that I've been able to see get rich in their 20s and 30s and exactly how they've done it. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. As always, hope you brought a lot of value to you. If you don't mind, smash a thumbs up. Helps out the YouTube channel massively. I know you can't pay me in direct money, but you can pay me in a thumbs up, okay? And I do appreciate that very much. Also, if you want to check out that free stock investing Discord chat, the best in the world, stock Pinterest.hub. Go ahead and check it out. It is going to be the pinned comment down there. It's also linked in the description. Look forward to having you guys in there. It's crazy. I can't believe how many members we already have. I mean, that's going to be nuts in like 3, 6, 9, 12 months from now. That's all I've got to say. Thank you for watching and have a great day.